Hey guys, I'm Mark and I'm having a problem with my cucumbers. Like a lot of you, I'm starting to see downy mildew appear on my cucumbers. And I know that's what it is because, well, for a few reasons. Number one, looking at the leaves, they're starting to get these yellow spots to them. And then principally on the underside of the leaves, I'm starting to see this grayish, sort of dark, almost mold looking kind of stuff, especially centered on where the yellow spot is on the inverse side. This is typical for this time in the season, especially if you live in an area like mine where it's very, very humid and hot during the summer and you have those real warm nights. Those are very nice conditions for fungi of all types to thrive, really. But usually for me, in my case, this type of situation doesn't happen until a little bit later in the situation, a little bit later in the season for this particular crop. Usually I get my first batch of cucumbers in a lot earlier than I did this year. So by now, like typically I would get 2, 3, 4 harvests off of these guys before I'd wind up having this issue. And in that event, what I typically do is I just rip the plants out and start over from scratch. I just get rid of them. I take them to another part of the farm and I make sure that they don't sort of cross contaminate anything else in the garden, at least as best as I can. But for this situation, this is a relatively young crop and I'm just starting to pull my first harvest out of here. You can see these are pickling cucumbers. The variety is called Eureka F1. It's a very nice pickling cucumber. It's extremely prolific. But I want to get ahead of this downy mildew and I'm going to try combating it in a few ways. Number one, what I'm going to do is I'm going to prune and I'm just going to clean these plants up really well and improve the airflow. Fungi do not like stagnant air. It doesn't dry, you know, if the air is not moving, it's not drying the plant out a whole lot. So if I can get a whole lot of this leaf matter out here, a lot of these lower leaves, just this dense foliage that's down in here, kind of, you know, just sort of clear that out of the way. After I'm done with that, I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to fertilize. Fertilizing this plant is going to help just boost the plant's natural systems. It's just going to help the plant get healthier and fight off the downy mildew as best as it can, just with a little bit of help from the fertilizer. What that fertilizer is it's just Garden Tone, Spoma Garden Tone, 1 cup of that mixed in with 5 gallons of water. And I just let that sit for an hour and then I transfer it into these watering containers here. And I'm going to use up all 5 gallons on this, what I've got. I've got 44 feet of cucumbers here, and 5 gallons ought to be plenty sufficient for right now as far as that goes. I'll hit it again, maybe in another 2 weeks, just to give it a supplemental boost. But that's going to be the second thing, is fertilizing. And then the third thing that I'm going to do, the last thing in all these steps, is I'm going to wind up spraying the cucumbers down once I've eliminated a lot of this foliage and I've got a much smaller target to work with. So for right now, my first step is I want to clear out all the remaining cucumbers that are on there. I'm just going to go ahead and harvest all these guys, clean up the bed, get it nice and prepared, and then the morning I'm going to spray. You always like to do your spraying in the morning. It's just, in this specific situation, I don't want to spray at night because I don't want to leave the leaves wet. They're dealing with enough of that as it is. So I'm going to wait until the morning time before the sun really starts beating down on these, get them a good dose, and then just sort of let them dry out throughout the day. But before I do spray in the morning, what I want to do is very important. Whenever you're spraying any kind of plant foliage, you always want to do a test spot. And basically what you're testing for is phytotoxicity. And that just means is the plant going to react in a negative way to what you're spraying on it? Are you going to cause any damage or any sort of ill effects? And the best place that I'm going to spray for a test is young foliage. I want to hit the young tender stuff, because if anything's going to have a problem with this, it's going to be the young soft fleshy tissue. So I've already hit a few leaves all the way up at the top of the plant here earlier, just a light dusting, you know, get a good little piece of it, remember which one you hit, and then in the morning I'll come out and just make sure that that looks the same way that it does right now. Well, the light's fading and I've got a lot of work ahead of me cleaning these guys up and harvesting what I have hanging on these vines so far. I see Holly's been helping me with with picking some of the cucumbers. I think she's eating one right now, actually. Yes, she is. But I'm gonna clear all these up, and then I will see you guys first thing in the morning and show you what I'm spraying and how I do it. Good morning, guys. I stayed up late last night getting these cucumbers all pruned up. I just kept on going until I couldn't see anymore. And then I came out early this morning and did an additional cleaning up here and there. My main focus of what I was trying to do is just increase airflow as best as I could. So I got a lot of the vines out here that were growing in really thick, where they were sort of just competing with one another and getting a little crowded. And then my main focus was to get a lot of the foliage out from underneath and improve airflow down there. All my cuttings that I took off, all this stuff that I've been clipping out of here, I'm gonna round up into a pile and I'm gonna get it out of here as soon as I can, get it far away from these plants and any other things in my garden that that they might contaminate, especially cucumbers that I'm gonna be planting here in a few days. I wanna just try to remove them from the situation as best as I can. If you don't have a place far away on the property that you can take these, then you can always just bag them up and just get them out of there. But anyway, while I was in here pruning, I went ahead and I harvested all the cucumbers that were ready. You can see I got a little more than a bushel. These are 6.5 gallon containers and they're almost full. Again, these are Eureka F1 cucumbers, which are very, very disease resistant as they are. I'm surprised that I have an infection as bad as I do, really. I mean, Downy Mildew, Powdery Mildew, Mosaic Virus, across the board, this is a pretty tough cucumber. So I'm gonna do my best to try to save them. I've never done this before. I'm gonna preface with that. Usually, like I said, when they get this bad or when they start to get like this, I'll rip them out, because by that time I've usually got a few harvests out of there. But for today's sake, we're gonna see what we can do. What I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna spray them with a solution that I made up last night. And this solution is in a 1 gallon sprayer. And the recipe is 1 gallon of water. And in that I put 2 tablespoons of baking soda, 1 teaspoon of dishwasher soap, like dishwasher soap that you would use in your sink, not in your dishwasher. It's just the liquid stuff. 1 teaspoon of that, and then 1 ounce of neem oil. So what the soap doesn't really do anything regarding tackling the fungi itself. It acts more as what's called a surfactant. And what that means is it changes the way that the water droplet interacts with the surface of the leaf when it hits it. Basically, it gets it to spread out more, it sticks better, and you just get a much better coverage in the end. And that's important, especially with things that have a very fuzzy or spiny surface like cucumbers do. The baking soda, what that does is it lowers the pH on the surface of the leaf. Fungi do not like a basic environment. So if you can raise the pH on the surface of the leaf with the baking soda, then that just makes it a little less conducive of an environment for them to thrive. And then the neem oil just acts as a natural fungicide. The way you want to mix this up is you're going to want to get your small parts all together first. Don't just fill it up with water and then dump the things in and shake it up. It may not mix, it may not incorporate all that well if you do it that way. It might separate. So what I do is I take my baking soda and then I add my neem oil to that and mix it around and mix the soap in. And then once that's all nice and mixed up and well incorporated, I'll add a little bit of water, mix that in, and then just add more and more water and then fill the jug up. Well, I'll do that in a cup first, and then I'll fill the cup up with water. I'll mix it, dump that in here, and then fill the jug up the rest of the way and shake it around. And that's just a really good way to get things nice and incorporated. Periodically, I'm going to shake it, but not too often. Anyway, my test spot looks really good from last night. There's no changes or anything going on there. It looks perfectly normal, so I'm going to be safe enough to spray. The sun is low enough in the sky still. It's not beating down on these. So I'm going to go ahead and show you how I do this part of it. The main thing that you're going to want to hit is going to be the undersides of the leaves. And let me show you real quickly why that is. I never showed you this close up, but let's see if I can get a leaf that's pretty infected here. Okay. So this is what downy mildew looks like. First sign you're gonna see is you're gonna see these yellow spotting, so that speckly pattern on top. But then the telltale is when you turn the leaf over and you can see on the underside of the leaf, you got that like gray, fuzzy mold. It's like dark. Those are the fruiting bodies, and those are where the spores are coming out of. And this is where all the action is taking place. So the main goal is to try to get as much of those undersides of the leaves sprayed as best as you can. My sprayer, I love these little gallon sprayers because they're cheap, they're inexpensive. I can fill up there's a lot of different things that I might be spraying out of these. And sometimes depending on what it is, you might not use all of it, and it's perfectly fine to just leave the extra in the sprayer. And so to have several on hand is really pretty handy. But before I do spray, I want to make sure I get rid of these cucumbers, because they're probably gonna taste a lot better if they don't have neem oil or soap on them. So let me just get these back here a ways. All right, now we should be ready to rock and roll. So my sprayer's all pumped up. Yep, I've got the setting on there so that it's got a wide pattern like that. You can just adjust this nozzle on here to make more of a stream, more of a wider pattern. But I'll just start right at the front end and I'll get down low and just kind of spray up into the plant, just like that. That's where it really comes in handy to remove a lot of those lower leaves, because they're not getting in the way, and I can get a much better contact this way. But try to get everything as saturated best you can. And then once I make my way all the way down to the end of the line, then I'll come back and I'll hit the top sides and just give them a light dusting. Now I'm gonna do this now, and then I'm gonna come back and I'm gonna do this one more time about a week from now, because I just fertilized these plants and they're gonna send out a lot of new tender growth, and that new tender growth is gonna be susceptible or more susceptible to this powdery mildew. So once it starts sending out some of that new tissue, I'm gonna wanna hit it right away, maybe let it harden off a little bit first, so that, I mean, I'm gonna judge based on if I see any damage that's localized to the tips of these things, to the young growth. I mean, if they look fine tomorrow, perfectly fine, then I'll go ahead and spray these again in another 4 or 5 days or a week. But if I see any damage happening up here, then I might hold off a little later than that, just to give that new growth time to just sort of toughen up a little bit. So anyway, that's how I'm gonna spray these guys. I'm not totally sure how it's gonna work out. The way I'm gonna show you how it works out is I'm just gonna mention this in the next garden tour video that I'll do. We'll just touch on this and we can kind of see how things are progressing. If you have any experience with dealing with downy mildew and you find something that works well, or something that you've used in the past, please leave a comment, send me an email, let us know, you know, some of the things. I mean, there's a lot of different ways that you can treat this. I've seen people spraying everything from mouthwash to milk on downy mildew. So if you got something that comes to mind, please, please, please let us hear about it. So anyway, that's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna spray all these down. I might have to mix up another gallon or two of this stuff in order to get everything sprayed very evenly, but we're gonna see what happens. So for right now, thank you guys very much for watching, and I'll see you next time.